Alex!
Alex Wesker. It can't be the same woman. Where's Moira? What have you done with her?
Buried her and the rest of them beneath a mountain of fear and despair.
You killed her.
There's one more to kill.
It was Alex Wesker. She's responsible for the experiment 6 months ago.
They called her the Overseer.
She took Moira away from me. And now I'll never get... And all for fucking what? I'm sorry.
It's okay. She said she was going to be reborn.
Reborn how? With a virus? Why did she need my little girl? Doesn't make any sense.
I'm sorry. I can't remember anything else.
Oh, sweetie, I'm sorry. It's my problem, not yours. Just take it easy.
Barry, are you okay?
Yeah, I was just thinking about how I used to go for walks like this with Moira and Polly.
Were you a good family?
We tried to be. Moira and I fought a lot. Even after she grew up.
Was it because she used bad words?
No. She just did that to tick me off. I'm the one that drove us apart. I messed up real bad as a father. She and Polly were playing in the house. I forgot to lock up my guns, and Moira... Polly had an accident.
Was it Moira's fault?
No. It was mine. But I raised my voice at her, and I guess I never really got around to taking the blame. Polly survived, thank God. But not me and Moira. We started drifting apart.
I think she still loved you.
I appreciate you saying that. I'll tell you this much. I couldn't save her, but I'm gonna save you. I promise I'll get you off this island.
I know. Thanks, Barry.
Wow. I'm more interested in this story than fucking the other story. Like, it's more interesting hearing Barry's shit. I'm finding out, like, as I'm playing. Like, I'm more interested in what happens with Barry. Not that I don't care about Clara. Obviously, Moira plays a big part in Barry's role, but, like, I was looking forward to playing this part. It just made sense. So we've already been here. Technically. That was a cool story, though. Definitely needed to hear that. Back to the surface. Alright. Back to basics, and hopefully things will calm down. And not be so cheap or really difficult. I changed it back to the hardest mode, just in case you were wondering. But I'm enjoying Barry's presence in this game, and maybe that's why I'm attracted to his part of the episode a little bit more. And it's not because they're hard and the other ones, no, but, you know. But this episode was probably the hardest of them all, as far as challenge.
Yeah, are you?
Alright. Oof. Barry's still got the moves. This has three. A decoy bottle. Anything up here? At least we kind of know where some stuff is, considering we've been here before. Well, I hope you guys are enjoying this LP, all challenges aside. I guess that's part of the fun. Which is why a lot of people like The Evil Within. I didn't have to lower the difficulty on that, but this, I just didn't want to be there forever. If I had all the time in the world, I would just have sat there and just been like, eh. But my time's even less fucking, you know, like, available to me now than it was even when I recorded Evil Within, to be honest. But that was just really difficult. I really don't even know what that was and why it was so hard, but it just seemed fucking impossible. Whether it was just not enough ammo or something. Not enough health to, like, take out, you know. Are they all coming to life? Because at this point, I'm not killing them all. shit. Fuck these things. Damn. Oh, he's dead.
See?
Yeah. Leave him be.
Poor man. He died all alone.
This is Moira's. Let's go.
Damn,
I'm gonna wreck this island for what it did to her.
I wanna know what happened, to be honest. 1988. Mining business goes well. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, wow, so you lived here. All right. Call her a savior, a benefactor, my mother always said. I would not leave, no place to go, so I go to the sewers. I stay here, things will get worse, I know it. We're gonna be safe. Wow, that's some backstory. I like Natalia too, she's a really cool character.
Let's get out of here first. Stay close, okay?
I will.
Oh, that's where we got chased. How could I forget that already? God.
dead end. Looks like we can open the sluice from higher up.
All right.
Harry, there's a hole.
I know I'm hurt now. Damn, she can jump.
There's something ahead. Be careful.
All right. Now I just gotta open this now. That works. The ultimate team, Barry and Natalia. They do make a pretty good team. For a little girl that can see enemies and shit. I mean, she's experimented on, which we learned earlier, so maybe that has something to do with why she can see things ahead of time. Alright. Grab this, grab this. Open this. What's in here? Hanging ammo. Shoot this thing in my way.
Thanks.
No problem.
Natalia, the sluice.
Got it.
Why can't you keep turning? Holy shit. fuck off. Barry, Jesus. Come on, Barry, can you handle yourself if I switch out? God damn it.
There's something ahead. Be careful.
The sluice. Where are you, Natalia? This calls for me to control her. This is kind of cool, switching in and out. It's kind of challenging. It's not too crazy, though. Yet. Come on, you got this, you got this.
Natalia, see if you can get this open.
Got it.
Natalia, you got this. I just gotta go under here. Sweet. Damn. bitch. Fuck off me. Oh, shit. Alright, well, he's just gonna keep crawling, and, that'll work. Gives Barry more time to come in and kick your ass.
Still in one piece?
I'm a sluice master. The master of sluicing. Up here. Oh god. I don't have that much to deal with this. Alright. Let's see what's under here. Oh, outside.
Okay, we're out. Now to pick up Wesker's trail.
Right.
You know, you don't have to come with me for this.
I'm saying, I want to know the truth about Mrs. Eden.
Once upon a time, this must have been some kind of mine.
It was. According to what we read, it was. I don't know how to give people a lot of jobs, according to the note that we read.
Harry, I think I remember something. I think that woman used to be down there somewhere.
Okay. Let's head down and look for a way across.
Well, you know, that's not going to be easy.
The old sack is going to pay for what she did to Moira. I'm not leaving this island until she does.
Can't shoot that emblem. What the hell? Smoke powder. Now we combine this. Now we got three. Pass that. Eight rounds, that's useful. But I guess every bullet counts. Stealth kill. Got an achievement from the shadows. Achievement on Steam, anyway. Alright, well, let's have her look around, see if she can see anything. Let's see. Up here, maybe?
The only way up is that elevator. Looks like the whole power source has been removed. We'll have to find a replacement to get this baby moving.
Oh, it's Resident Evil. It's not that easy. Always involves a battery. It's time to just explore and see what's what is worth looking for. Gee, I'm up there.
What was that?
Shit. Well, let's find out. That's what we saw on camera.
Good God, what a mess.
I'm gonna be sick.
We could probably use this power source.
What is this for?
This one's dead too.
We gotta do something, though. Wait, there's gotta be something. Let's see. Could we use, like, that doesn't... Is there anything over here? No. I'm so confused at what that is trying to imply. She injected us a little something. I don't know what it is, but they start to itch their bodies and just fall apart. Ouroboros. God help! Pop, 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 pop. That them trying to reinvent Itchy Tasty. It ain't gonna happen, Capcom. Nice try. RE4 barrel. What the fuck? Come on. Gotta grab this herb for me. Alright, so that supplies power, but maybe there's something that we're missing. Maybe now, if we go back and put that on where it's supposed to be. Maybe just go up here.
A power switch for the conveyor belt. That should help me get things from point A to point B.
You or Natalia, because you don't seem to be wanting to go on there. What are they... What are you doing, Barry? See if I can stealth kill this guy. Two of them. Can't use those switches. And what do those belts do, though? He says get him to point A to point B. He can't go in the belt. What the hell? There's gotta be more than... What, I can't click this? Hold up. Something is wrong. Maybe we shouldn't have fucked with this thing. Because nothing's working, so... Why would they let you pick it up? If that's what it does, I don't know. I don't know. Like, you send her under there for something, and it's not to break a crate, which you can't even do. No, nothing. Well, what the hell? Then what are you talking about, point A to point B? You can't... You're not getting under the fucking belt. Okay, I'm trying to see. That's as far as she gets. What the fuck? What is this for? Nothing. Can't use that. This maybe? Okay. We gotta carry it that far. Shit. They want us to do extra backtrack and forward and backtrack and forward and backtrack and forward. Alright. That's alright though. It's expected. I figured, but that doesn't... I don't know. I still don't get what he was trying to say, but... Wait, unless we put it on the belt and it comes out that way. I think that's what he wants. Yeah. That would only make sense. There we go. Holy shit. It's a Ouroboros.
What the hell is that thing?
Yeah. I ever gonna die? Like... We could just dip. Oh, we can't dip. Jesus Christ. No ammo whatsoever. Maybe we gotta go out the window now. That's what it's implying, yeah. Alright, well now we should be able to use these switches to our advantage, I guess? Please tell me now the switches do something. Oh yeah, we need to get the thing from the belt. Right.
I'll throw my back out if I try to lug this thing all the way to the elevator.
That's why we use the belt. Poor Barry, man. He's getting old, like everybody else. Works for me. So now we gotta put this in the elevator. Do we have to do something with these switches here? That's something, all right. Very puzzle oriented this episode. Let's see. That's a problem. How the hell else we get it up there? You have to unlock the door somehow. It's the only way. All right, maybe up here. Trying to link it to the belts, but it still doesn't make sense. Yeah, like, why can't we unlock? Like, are we missing a key? We have to be missing a key. It's locked from the other side. Unless we use this. Alright. Awesome. Sweet. Get our thinking caps on for this one. Sweet, so now we got a way of getting it up there. That's cool. I kind of like this feeling that Capcom is actually putting stuff like this back in Resident Evil games. That's kind of cool. I kind of miss this feeling, to be honest, where you kind of have to think. Resident Evil 6 had, like, no puzzle. It was maybe the picture wall puzzle, but I mean, still, shit, this is a step up. I mean, compared to, I didn't even talk about it on the new podcast episode we just did, because, hell, I didn't play this episode yet. Kind of cool to have, like, parts like this where it's not all, you know, like, the same shooting. It switches it up a bit, you know? It doesn't let it get, like, too stale. Some people could find this boring. Hell, some people could find this LP boring. But I'm thinking, so. Gotta think, man. I miss it, though. It's cool. Good job with this part. The other part of this episode, oh my god. What the fuck, man? That was just hard and frustrating. Ugh. All right. No, don't hop on it. Peace. Oh, shit.
Oh, come on. Not now. Damn it.
My words exactly. Shit. Are you stuck?
Monster!
But I'm nowhere near. Barry, don't come running back. I swear to fucking God. If you do, stop. Alright, now that she's caught up, I can try to stealth kill these guys. Or they already know that I'm here. Or not? Okay. I'll take it. There we go. Sweet. In just 3 days. That's great. Lovely numbers. Lovely numbers. Alrighty. I see where this goes. Oh my goodness. Really? Really? Are you fucking kidding me? Really? A one-hit kill? Of course. It'd be too easy to just hurry up and run past this part, which I clearly don't have enough ammo for. Why do they send everything out? God, I don't know how I'm gonna do this now. Now my mood's killed. Things were just moving nicely, and now... the ultimate 2-hour part. I hate the fact that it's so long, guys. I'm sorry. I know it's my first time playing, but like, I don't want this part to go on forever. I should just take care of these guys first. We gotta do knife battle now. With a one-hit kill enemy. Any more ammo around here? There's a ruby. You could throw bricks at it, but does that really do anything? Because he literally turns on me. You fucking kidding me? It does that much damage? That much damage? Fuck this noise. Get the fuck out of here. I'm not getting stuck on you. You probably weren't even supposed to do that, but I have no ammo. And, you know, the game just wants me to knife it. I'm not doing that. Literally, the amount of damage he did was insane.
Let's keep at it. We'll have that old bitch cornered soon.
Barry means it. Don't fuck with Barry's daughters. Any of them.
My hair turned gray and the flesh sag from my bones. But why aren't you changing? A failure like you. I'll crush you with my bare hands.
Next time on Revelations 2.
My whole life has been a prelude to this. My true birth.
Wherever she went, we could still catch her.
Nice fucking emergency exit!
Down below. I think that's where we'll find her.
Time to meet the cause of our misery.
You will die, child.
Run, 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 run!
All that remains is one final test.
Another good cliffhanger. What power does Natalia possess? Guess we'll find out next time. I'll commend them for this. They do keep it interesting with the episodes. Not bad. I like the result screen music as well. It's kind of nice. That's kind of useful. All right, guys. That's it for this episode. Better late than never, I guess. But like I said, I've been busy. But thank you guys for keeping up with my anger and frustration when things get tough. There's some tough things in this game, and you guys can tell, that are just a little bit too cheap if I'm not being too biased because I'm playing it on the hard mode, and people could be like, well, why don't you just play on normal and stop fucking complaining? Because there's some things that just don't... Like, sometimes the enemy placement, it just feels, like, too overwhelming, but, like, not in a sense where, like, it would be a good thing, if that makes sense. I don't know. You get what I'm saying? It's just... Yeah. I hope you do. I mean, you could see it. It's all on video. It's not like it was a bad episode. It's just like, holy shit, like, I couldn't beat fucking... Neil Nemesis, whatever you want to fucking call him. I wouldn't even call him Nemesis, that's not Nemesis, but Neil, that was insane. But thank you for sticking with me and all that shit. So I'll catch you guys in the next one, the final episode. So hopefully I can record them when they come out as well, because I have a busy week ahead of me, going to Perry's and stuff like that later this week coming up. So I'm not going to have time to edit. So hopefully I can get everything done. So there's going to be a lot going on. But anyway, till next time. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for putting up with this and all of my mistakes and whatnot. And hope you're having fun and enjoying Revelations too. And I hope you guys enjoyed the podcast as well. It's doing positive as always, thankfully. So I'm grateful and thankful. We all are. See you guys in the next one.